This is Mission Control Houston. Welcome to today's ISS update. It is Tuesday, October 16th, 2012. You're looking at a live view inside the Space Station Flight Control Room here at the Johnson Space Center. This is the Orbit 2 team that is currently on duty. They are working with the Expedition 33 crew members on board the orbiting complex. Right now, the space station is high above Turkey at an altitude of 263 miles. It is heading up toward the northeast over parts of Kazakhstan, Russia, and parts of Asia. The crew is very busy today working on a variety of different experiment work and research work on board the orbiting complex. The commander of Expedition 33, Sonny Williams, started off her morning working with the European Modular Cultivation System, or EMCS. She was opening up some of the gas module valves that are part of that research facility. This is a large incubator on board the space station that serves as a growth chamber for different types of small plants. That particular incubator can actually simulate different forces of gravity. It can either have no gravity like they do up in space, or it can have two times the gravity you would find here on Earth. And all that is designed to find out what kind of effects plants see while they're up in space with the crew members. She also has a ham radio pass with a school in Spain. She's also performing an acoustic survey of the space station environment. The ground teams here instruct the crew members throughout their time on board the space station to basically monitor their home, monitor the complex. They take a variety of different samples around the orbiting laboratory, including the sound environment, just to make sure that the sound levels with all of that machinery and computers and all the acoustics there are acceptable. So she will send down the results of that later on today. She also has an onboard training tag up, as we call it here at NASA, just a quick conference call with some of the ground controllers here in Houston as they get ready for the end of the SpaceX Dragon mission coming up at the end of the month. Sonny Williams, as well as Aki Hoshide, her fellow Expedition 33 crew member, were a key part of capturing the Dragon back last week and installing it toward the end of this month. Once that spacecraft is full of all the items that are going to come back home to Earth, they will basically be reversing the process using the station's arm that you saw there on the outside of the station to grab onto Dragon once again, to remove it from the space station and to send it on its way. So they're going to have a conference call later on today with some of the ground controllers who will be working with them on that. She, as well as Aki Hoshide, also today are taking a look at some of the proposed procedures for the upcoming spacewalk that may take place toward the end of this month or the early part of November. As we speak here today on ISS Update, the space station program management team is meeting to talk exactly what will take place during that spacewalk, whether we're going to have one or two. But the main focus of the procedures are to look at this ammonia leak that the team has seen on the P6 radiator. The P6 truss is one of the far out trusses out there on the left-hand side of the station. There's an ammonia leak on part of the radiator there that has increased here recently. So they're going to come up with a way for the crew members to go out there and mitigate that. And once the space station program control board approves all of that, we'll have information for you here on NASA television as well as on NASA.gov in terms of what day that spacewalk will take place and exactly what will be involved in it. Aki Hoshide is performing an analysis of some of the water on board the space station today. He is setting up some radiation monitors throughout the space station. As we talked about, Sonny Williams is doing some sampling of the sound and the acoustics on board. Aki Hoshide is setting up some sensors that will measure over the next several weeks what the radiation levels are, and that data will be downlinked to the ground teams as well. He is changing out some batteries on some of the laboratory systems on board. He's also working with what's called the Microbe 3 experiment, which takes a look at bacteria inside the Kibo laboratory. That is the Japanese facility on board the station. That just takes a look at different fungi and bacteria that are growing in there, things that the human eye can't see. And that will help combat things as we look toward going on longer space flights to an asteroid and on to Mars one day. Obviously, you want to have as sterile of an environment as you possibly can in your spaceship. As we mentioned, he's also going to be taking part in that Dragon training conference call with the ground teams to figure out what the crew's going to be doing once Dragon departs. And then Yuri Malenchenko, the other flight engineer on board, is working in the Russian segment. He is working on part of an experiment that looks at circadian rhythms. Obviously, most people here on Earth know what that is, or your body and how it reacts to daylight and nighttime. It's a little bit different whenever you're up in space and you see more than a dozen sunrises and sunsets per day. Your body clock gets thrown off a little bit, so they're going to be taking a look at that. He's going to be wearing some instrumentation over the next several hours as they monitor how his body reacts to the space station environment. He's also going to be doing a fitness evaluation today, spending about an hour and a half on the treadmill inside the Russian segment. Obviously, an exercise is an important part of the crew members' daily activities. Down at the Baikonur Cosmodrome, while the crew is up in space, their fellow crew members that are going to be joining them as part of Expedition 33, Oleg Novitsky, Evgeny Tarelkin, and Kevin Ford, which you see there, are undergoing final preparations for their launch. That launch is coming up on October 23rd at 5:51 a.m. Central Time. That is 6:51 a.m. Eastern Time. They'll be launching on a Soyuz rocket. Of course, we'll have live coverage here on NASA television, as well as of their docking 2 days later on October 25th. That docking is scheduled for 7:35 a.m. Central Time, 8:35 a.m. Eastern Time.